In this module, we shall study about the objectives of financial statements. The objective of financial statements is to provide information about the financial position, performance, and changes in financial position of an entity that is useful to a wide range of users in making economic decisions. After studying this module, you shall be able to know about the balance sheet, know about the key elements, understand the profit and loss account, derive the cash flow statement, understand the relationship between financial statements. Now, let us discuss about balance sheet. The balance sheet, also called statement of financial position, supplies information on resources the organization currently control, where they come from, and who has claims against them. Statement of financial position helps users of financial statements to assess the financial wealth of an entity. When analyzed over several accounting periods, balance sheet may assist in identifying underlying trends in the financial position of the entity. It is particularly helpful in determining the state of the entity's liquidity risk, financial risk, credit risk, and business risk. When used in conjunction with other financial statements of the entity and the financial statement of its competitors, balance sheet may help to identify relationships and trends which are indicative of potential problems or areas for further improvement. Analysis of the statement of financial position could therefore assist the users of financial statements to predict the amount, timing, and volatility of entities' future earnings. Among other things, the balance sheet provides information that helps you answer the following questions. First, how large is the firm in terms of the amount of total resources? Second, how much have the owners invested in the organization? What proportion of the owners' funds have been brought in fresh, and what proportion represents past profit held and accumulated in the organization as additional owners' investment? Third, how much money is borrowed by the organization? Can it borrow more in case of needs? When are the borrowings due for repayment, and is the organization in a healthy position to pay them on time? Fourth, what kind of resources does the organization have? Are most of the resources are committed to its present activities, or it can move rapidly into new business opportunities? Fifth, how much cash does the organization have? How much cash can it obtain quickly? How much money is owed to it, and how much money it owes to others? The balance sheet is the position statement which shows where the company stands in financial terms at a specific date. Underline the words position statement and specific date. As discussed earlier, the balance sheet is a snapshot view of the assets and liabilities of the organization at a point in time. The balance sheet reports the resources of the company, the assets, the company's obligations, the liabilities, and the owner's equity, which represents the difference between what is owned assets and what is owed liabilities. Statement of financial position consists of the following key elements. Assets. An asset is something that an entity owns or controls in order to derive economic benefits from its use. Assets must be classified in the balance sheet as current or non-current depending on the duration over which the reporting entity expects to derive economic benefit from its use. An asset which will deliver economic benefits to the entity over the long term is classified as non-current, whereas those assets that are expected to be realized within 1 year from the reporting date are classified as current assets. Assets are also classified in the statement of financial position on the basis of their nature, tangible and intangible. Non-current assets with physical substance are classified as property, plant and equipment, whereas assets without any physical substance are classified as intangible assets. Goodwill is a type of an intangible asset. Inventories balance includes goods that are held for sale in the ordinary course of the business. Inventories may include raw material, finished goods and works in progress. Trade receivables include the amounts that are recoverable from customers upon credit sales. Trade receivables are presented in the statement of financial position after the deduction of allowance for bad debts. Cash and cash equivalents include cash in hand along with any short-term investments that are readily convertible into known amounts of cash. Liabilities. A liability is an obligation that a business owes to someone and its settlement involves the transfer of cash or other resources. Liabilities must be classified in the statement of financial position as current or non-current depending on the duration over which the entity intends to settle the liability. A liability which will be settled over the long term is classified as non-current, whereas those liabilities that are expected to be settled within 1 year from the reporting date are classified as current liabilities. Liabilities are also classified in the statement of financial position on the basis of their nature. Trade and other payables primarily include liabilities due to suppliers and contractors for credit purchases. Sundry payables, which are too insignificant to be presented separately on the face of the balance sheet, are also classified in this category. Short-term borrowings typically include bank overdrafts and short-term bank loans with a repayment schedule of less than 12 months. Long-term borrowings comprise of loans which are to be repaid over a period that exceeds 1 year. Current portion of long-term borrowings include the installments of long-term borrowings that are due within 1 year of the reporting date. Current tax payable is usually presented as a separate line item in the statement of financial position due to the materiality of the amount. Equity. Equity is what the business owes to its owners. Equity is derived by deducting total liabilities from the total assets. It therefore represents the residual interest in the business that belongs to the owners. Equity is usually presented in the statement of financial position under the following categories. Share capital represents the amount invested by the owners in the entity. Retained earnings comprises the total net profit or loss retained in the business after distribution to the owners in the form of dividends. Revaluation reserve contains the net surplus of any upward revaluation of property, plant and equipment recognized directly in equity. The balance sheet is structured in a manner that the total assets of an entity equal to the sum of liabilities and equity. This may lead you to wonder as to why the balance sheet must always be in equilibrium. Assets of an entity may be financed from internal sources, that is, share capital and profits, or from external credit, example, bank loan, trade creditors, etc. Since the total assets of a business must be equal to the amount of capital invested by the owners, that is, in the form of share capital and profits not withdrawn and any borrowings, the total assets of a business must equal to the sum of equity and liabilities. This leads us to the accounting equation. Assets is equal to liabilities plus equity. Next, moving on to the profit and loss account. The profit and loss account, also known as income statement, provides information on the efficiency of utilization of resources in obtaining current revenues, the current profitability of the organization. Among other things, it helps you answer the following questions. First, how large is the firm in terms of its total volume of sales? Second, what are the profitability levels of the organization? When compared with similar organizations in the same business, is the organization making more or less profit? Third, what is the trend of the profitability? Are profits remaining proportionate to changes in the volume of business activities, or they are proportionately increasing or decreasing? Fourth, compared with other similar organizations, are the cost of doing business proportionately the same in relation to sales, or higher, lower? Fifth, since profitability is one indicator of debt paying ability, is the organization in a good position to repay its bills promptly? Are profits more than adequate to cover current interest cost? The profit and loss account is an activity statement that shows details and results of the company's profit related activities for a period of time. For example, a month, 3 months, 6 months or year. It reports the amount of net income earned by a company during a period, with annual and quarterly income statements being the most common. Net income is the excess of a company's revenue over its expenses. If the expenses are more than the revenues, then the company has suffered a loss for the period. Income statement provides the basis for measuring performance of an entity over the course of an accounting period. Performance can be assessed from the income statement in terms of the following: change in sales revenue over the period and in comparison to industry growth, change in gross profit margin, operating profit margin and net profit margin over the period, increase or decrease in net profit, operating profit and gross profit over the period, comparison of the entity's profitability with other organizations operating in similar industries or sectors. Income statement also forms the basis of important financial evaluation of an entity when it is analyzed in conjunction with information contained in other financial statements, such as change in earnings per share over the period, analysis of working capital in comparison to similar income statement elements, example, the ratio of receivables reported in the balance sheet to the credit sales reported in the income statement, that is debtor turnover ratio, analysis of interest cover and dividend cover ratios. The profit and loss account represents the accountant's best effort at measuring the economic performance of a company. Components. Income statement comprises of the following main elements. Revenue. Revenue includes income earned from the principal activities of an entity. So, for example, in case of a manufacturer of electronic appliances, revenue will comprise of the sales from electronic appliance business. Conversely, if the same manufacturer earns interest on its bank account, it shall not be classified as revenue but as other income. Next, cost of sales. Cost of sales represents the cost of goods sold or services rendered during an accounting period. Hence, for a retailer, cost of sales will be the sum of inventory at the start of the period and purchases during the period minus any closing inventory. In case of a manufacturer, however, cost of sales will also include production cost incurred in the manufacture of goods during a period, such as the cost of direct labor, direct material consumption, depreciation of plant and machinery, and factory overheads, etc. Other income. Other income consists of income earned from activities that are not related to the entity's main business. For example, other income of an entity that manufactures electronic appliances may include gain on disposal of fixed assets, interest income on bank deposits, exchange gain on transaction of a foreign currency bank account, distribution cost. Distribution cost includes expenses incurred in delivering goods from the business premises to customers. Next, administrative expenses. Administrative expenses generally comprise of costs relating to the management and support functions within an organization that are not directly involved in the production and supply of goods and services offered by the entity. Examples of administrative expenses include salary, cost of executive management, legal and professional charges, depreciation of head office building, rent expense of offices used for administration and management purposes, cost of functions departments not directly involved in production, such as finance department, HR department and administration department. Other expenses. This is essentially a residual category in which any expenses that are not suitably classifiable elsewhere are included. Finance charges. Finance charges usually comprise of interest expense on loans and debentures. The effect of present value adjustments of discounted provisions are also included in finance charges. Example, unwinding of discount on provision for decommissioning cost. Income tax. Income tax expense recognized during a period is generally comprised of the following three elements. First, current period's estimated tax charge. Second, prior period tax adjustments. Third, deferred tax expense. Let us now discuss about the cash flow statement. The cash flow statement provides information on how the organization is allocating the resources that were generated by the organization during the preceding year. It provides answers to the following types of questions. First, how much new resources were generated or obtained during the previous year? Second, where did these resources come from? Were additional resources obtained from creditors or the owners or from the profits retained in the business? Third, what has been done with these new resources generated? Are they being used to replace or expand the organization's building, equipment and similar items? What proportion is being used to retire debt or distributed to owners? The cash flow statement is an activity statement that shows the details of a company's activities involving cash during a period of time. The statement of cash flows reports the amount of cash collected and paid out by a company in the following three types of activities: operating, investing, and financing. The statement of cash flow is the most objective of the financial statement, since, as you will see in subsequent chapters, it involves a minimum of accounting estimates and judgments. Operating activities. Cash flow from operating activities presents the movement in cash during an accounting period from the primary revenue generating activities of the entity. For example, operating activities of a hotel will include cash inflows and outflows from the hotel business. Example, receipts from sales revenue, salaries paid during the year, etc. But interest income on a bank deposit shall not be classified as such. That is, the hotel's interest income shall be presented in investing activities. Profit before tax, as presented in the income statement, could be used as a starting point to calculate the cash flows from operating activities. Following adjustments are required to be made to the profit before tax to arrive at the cash flow from operations. Elimination of non-cash expenses, example depreciation, amortization, impairment losses, bad debts written off, etc. Removal of expenses to be classified elsewhere in the cash flow statement. Example, interest expense should be classified under financing activities. Elimination of non-cash income, example, gain on revaluation of investments. Removal of income to be presented elsewhere in the cash flow statement. Example, dividend income and interest income should be classified under investing activities unless in case of, for an example, an investment bank. Working capital changes, example, an increase in trade receivables must be deducted to arrive at sales revenue that actually resulted in cash inflow during the period. Next, investing activities. Cash flow from investing activities includes the movement in cash flow as a result of the purchase and sale of assets other than those which the entity primarily trades in. Example, inventory. So, for example, in case of a manufacturer of cars, proceeds from the sale of factory plant shall be classified as cash flow from investing activities, whereas the cash inflow from the sale of cars shall be presented under the operating activities. Cash flow from investing activities consists primarily of the following: cash outflow expended on the purchase of investments and fixed assets, cash inflow from income from investments, cash inflow from disposal of investments and fixed assets. Next, financing activities. Cash flow from financing activities includes the movement in cash flow resulting from the following: proceeds from issuance of share capital, debentures and bank loans, cash outflow expended on the cost of finance, that is dividends and interest expense, cash outflow on the repurchase of share capital and repayment of debentures and loans. Using information from the statement of cash flows, analysis using cash flow information is often restricted to an analysis of the relationships among the categories in the statement of cash flows. We do not perform vertical or horizontal analysis because, unlike the balance sheet and profit and loss account, there is no guarantee that a specific number from the statement of cash flows will consistently serve as the denominator for scaling purposes. For example, all balance sheet accounts are compared to total assets when preparing a vertical analysis of the balance sheet. Why? Because total asset is always going to be the biggest number on the balance sheet. The same is true for the profit and loss account. Total income is used because it is in almost every case the biggest number on the profit and loss account. In the case of the statement of cash flows, some years the cash flow from operations may be the largest number on the statement. In subsequent years, that number may be negative. Thus, horizontal and vertical analysis are rarely performed using the statement of cash flows because of scaling problems. Although the statement of cash flows, like the other financial statement, reports information about the past, and careful analysis of this information can help investors, creditors, and others assess the amount, timing, and uncertainty of future cash flows. Specifically, the statement helps user answers questions such as how a company is able to pay dividends when it had a net loss, or why a company is short of cash despite increased savings. A statement of cash flows may show, for example, that external borrowing or the issuance of equity shares provided the cash from which dividends were paid even though a net loss was reported for that year. Similarly, a company may be short on cash even with increased earnings because of increased inventory purchases, plant expansion, or debt retirement. Trends are often more important than absolute numbers for any one period. Accordingly, cash flow statements usually are presented on a comparative basis. This enables users to analyze a company's cash flows over a period of time. We shall now discuss the relation between the three statements. A balance sheet reports an organization's financial position at a point in time. The income and cash flow statements report on activities over a period of time. The two statements in the middle column of figure link balance sheet from the beginning to the end of a reporting period. They explain how the financial position of an organization changes from one point to another. As balance sheet is the starting point, we will discuss it in detail in the fifth chapter and follow it with profit and loss account and cash flow statement. Then we will discuss how to analyze these statements and other components of an annual report prepared by a company. Let us move on to discuss the relationship among the financial statements. If you have been following the preparation of the financial statements well, the interaction between the three financial statements would be clear to you by now. Let us summarize the relationship between the income statement and the balance sheet. First, the cost of the depreciable asset is charged as depreciation expense as the useful life of the asset expires. Second, as the inventory and supplies are used up, they become an expense in the income statement. Third, a part of the net profit from the income statement ends up in the reserves and surplus section of the owner's equity. Let us now summarize the relationships between the income statement, balance sheet, and the cash flow statement. First, in the cash from operating activities, the profit, depreciation, and indirect expenses come from income statement. Second, working capital changes, investing activities, and financing activities changes come from the comparison of the balance sheet of the starting and ending period. Let us now recapitulate what we have learned so far. Financial statement presents a formal record of the financial activities of an entity. These are written reports that quantify the financial strength, performance, and liquidity of a company. Financial statements reflect the financial effects of business transactions and events on the entity. Statement of financial position, also known as the balance sheet, presents the financial position of an entity at a given date. Income statement, also known as the profit and loss statement, reports the company's financial performance in terms of net profit or loss over a specified period. Cash flow statement presents the movement in cash and bank balances over a period. The relationship amongst the financial statement can be understood with the help of the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow.